to the men's race, and the big shock here was that South Korea didn't even qualify for the final, having been edged out in their semi. The race for gold, a relatively open one then, with the Koreans proving their point by smashing the Universiade record in the B final. Back to the A final though, it was the Canadians that got the best of the start. Guillaume Bastille, fresh from his bronze medal in the 1,000 metres, leading the way, followed by the teams from France, Russia and Hungary. For the French, their race all but over after just 1 minute. Vincent Jian bumping into one of the Russian team during the always frantic changeovers. Canada still leading. The Canadians hadn't won this title since its introduction to the Universiade back in 1985 in Bolano, and also in Italy. Down the stretch, and this had developed into a two-horse race between Patrick Duffy and Viktor Knoch. Both men desperately stretching for the line after a frantic final lap. But in the end, it would take a photograph to separate these two. France's fall, simply a racing incident, always a risk with so many skaters on the track. Well, even the photo finish was looking too close to call. In the end though, the result given to Hungary by mere 7 thousandths of a second, that their first medal of any kind in this event. Canada still looking for their second title then, with the Russians eventually cruising to the bronze medal after France's early fall. The short track speed skating finishing with a bang, plenty of excitement for the crowd in this 111.12 metre track, and great memories to take home with them too.